This video will show you how to bring the rain from your Day 3 dynamic setting project into this project. If you have not completed the dynamic setting, watch the videos from Day 3 and then come back to this video. If you have already completed the Day 3 project, continue watching this video. To make it rain in your story, use the rain from the dynamic setting projects. Open a new tab. In that tab, open the dynamic setting project. Probably requires you going to Scratch and looking in My Stuff. To take the rain from that project, put it in your backpack. Click on the triangle at the bottom of your screen to open the tab labeled Backpack. Then, drag the rain from the sprites area into the backpack. Now close that tab and go back to the tab for today's project. You need to refresh your browser page for it to show up in your backpack here. When you open the backpack tab now, you should see the rain sprite. Drag it into the sprites area of your project. The rain starts as soon as the green flag is clicked. You may want it that way, but in this example, it will be raining in the woods after the character walks through the secret door. To change when the rain starts, remove the When Green Flag is Clicked block and replace it with a When Backdrop Switches To block. In this example, the rain will start when the backdrop switches to woods. To hide the rain initially, add a When Backdrop Switches To Brick Wall block and place a Hide block after it. Add a Show block to the When Backdrop Switches To the Woods stack so that the rain appears after the character goes through the door. Okay, test this. When the green flag is clicked, there is no rain. After you type yes, the character should go through the secret door, and the rain should start. If you want the rain to start when the green flag is clicked and end in the woods, simply swap the events. You may notice that moving the rain changed its size. It may no longer fill the whole screen. You can try changing the size of the sprite with the Set Size To block. If that doesn't work, try copying the sprite by right-clicking on it and clicking Duplicate. Now you can change the placement and the speed of the rain until it looks right for your story. This example sets the X value to -160 in one sprite and to +160 in the other. This makes it look like the whole screen was raining. This example also moved the Y value from 100 to -100, making the rain fall from the top to the bottom of the screen. Try playing with different values until you find what works for your story. Now it's your turn. First, drag the rain sprite from the dynamic setting project into the backpack, and then into today's project. Second, change the events to hide and start the rain from the green flag to the appropriate backdrop. Finally, duplicate the rain sprite if you need to, and change the values to make the rain look like it's right in your new scene.